Now, to serious matters, we have a YouTube channel. Guys need to subscribe to the YouTube channel. Guys need to subscribe to the YouTube channel. Please, please, this is a personal
appeal
to the general public. Tafadhali, like subscribe to our YouTube channel.
We'll be giving you a lot of content during the week.
That's true.
Yeah, can keep you going and keep you informed, man.
This is going to be a very heated discussion, taking into account the fact that Njoro is a Man U fan. I'm an Arsenal fan. What do you think? How do you think it's going to go?
We're going to chop you guys so badly.
Never.
I'm telling you.
What makes you think that it's going to go
down? I don't know. See, you know, Arsenal somehow, they can't. When it comes to Man U, they have like an inferiority complex. Sorry to say. There's how even Man U approaches Arsenal games with some kind of feeling of, these guys again.
They're customers.
They're real customers.
Yeah.
But also, it'll be interesting because we'll be missing Ibrahimovic. And Arsenal will be missing
Sanchez. Yes.
So that's taking one world-class guy out of each team.
Yeah.
So I think Arsenal will go with Giroud leading the line, which is just fantastic
for you guys.
For us, because he won't do anything. That's what you think. Yeah, as in him, he's a bully. He better bully these two small teams. But when it comes to serious teams, he's always missing.
He can't hack.
Yeah.
You see, the good thing, the interesting thing about these big games is, one, it's never about your form coming into the game.
Yeah.
It's always about who matches up.
On the day,
who wins it. And I'll give you two examples. First one was last year. No, this year, actually, at Old Trafford.
Yeah.
Arsenal are the form team. We went there, what happened? 3-2 to United. That's when Rashford scored a brace.
Yeah.
I'll also take it now to the first game of the year, which was a year ago, in October last year, at Emirates. United are the form team, Arsenal are still struggling.
Yeah.
Arsenal ended up winning 3-0 that game. So it has nothing to do with who's the form team.
Current form is just on the day, who shows up.
Yeah. I feel that United, if they keep the form that has been, okay, from the last game, the
next one,
yeah, of course they were coming back. If they carry that momentum, then of course we end, coupled up by the fact that they're playing at home. And what we've just talked about, who brings it on the day.
And then also we have to mention the way Mourinho has been tearing into United players about their mentality.
Yeah.
No, that's the thing, all the pundits out there, like, was it really necessary?
Yeah.
But like Gary Neville said, it's, you can't really judge from outside.
Yes.
It's the coach who's seeing the inner workings, what's happening in the locker rooms and whatnot.
Yeah.
But he's even called for an inquisition into the whole medical department.
Yeah.
Because guys are just getting injured. He's wondering. Then he's also saying that
you hired the Arsenal guy.
There's a mole.
There's a mole.
Because even Ibra was saying there's a way that he thinks that in Man U, guys don't train as hard as they should.
Yeah.
Because him is used to intense training. He's saying that there's a way that the training for United, especially in terms of aerobics, that it's not intense.
Yes.
As intense as it should be. Because if you look at the stats, Man U has been running like the least miles.
Yeah.
One of four big teams.
Yes.
We've been running very few miles. I think we're like ranked 16th in terms of the ground covered per game.
Yeah.
So maybe there's something, but I'm sure Mourinho is doing his best to address that issue.
It's talent will win you games. I've always said that. Mm-hmm. Mourinho is a world class coach. He's won in Italy, he's won in Spain, he's won in England. He's a world class coach. Mm-hmm. Talent wins you games. Like, your mental strength is what wins you championships. He knows to what standards mental strength is supposed to be at.
Yeah.
So, just as you said and Gary Neville said, he knows what's happening inside the club, and therefore, if he says that these guys are not mentally up to it, you can tell, tell by the play that these guys are not up to it.
I think he was a bit unfair on Luke Shaw, because he criticized Luke Shaw's mentality.
Yeah.
But if Again, coming off that injury that he got, a double leg break.
Yeah.
Somehow, as in, such a guy, instead of castigating him,
yeah.
he needs an arm around his shoulder.
Yeah. yeah.
So, I don't think that was fair on Luke Shaw.
Yeah.
To criticize him.
I mean, the jury's out for that. We'll have to wait and see. But I on Arsenal's side, I think Wenger needs to hook up a very fluid midfield because you see he's been partnering up Xhaka with Coquelin. Now these two are holding midfielders, therefore they are going to give you what it is. They're going to break down play of the opposing team.
Yeah.
But in terms of going forward, you don't feel like they give you that fluidity. It's like a Matic. N'Golo Kante.
Yeah.
These guys are good at breaking down play, but then now the transition to the final third,
but
you don't get it from these guys.
It's not as quick. You see, Arsenal always suffer when Cazorla is out. Because, mate, I think Cazorla is the most important player for Arsenal.
That's true. I'm with
he you. Makes everything tick and he keeps the ball moving. Mm-hmm. And then he's the one who initiates that transition from defense to attack.
Yes.
He's perfect at it.
Yes.
I think he's the best, he's the most important player for Arsenal.
Yeah.
But also, Ozil. Oh, that guy is so romantic on the ball. But then when you watch Ozil play,
his ball is romantic.
Yeah,
he's like he's just over there some swag and he's
my only problem
can shut him down.
My only problem with Ozil has always been about his mental strength.
Mm.
There's no doubt that Ozil is, in terms of technical ability, top five players in the world right now.
Definitely.
But his issue is always just about mental strength. Like when it comes to the point where it's not your talent that's going to count. It's about your mental toughness.
Yeah.
That's where he loses his kid. When a game is tough, when you need that Ozil pass to unlock a defense.
Mm-hmm. Because somehow he goes with the flow. If the team is playing badly,
he's not
the guy who drags the team.
Yes,
forward. Exactly. I think if he was to take up more of that position, we'd be seeing him nominated for World Player of the Year. Arsenal would be taking trophies
all day. That's true. But we don't take away from the fact that he's technically gifted. And I think if Ozil plays on Sunday, then Arsenal will have a shot at winning at Old Trafford. If he doesn't play, then my guy.
Kwanza, if Pogba shows up, his that boy is talent. That goal he fungered there. What is Swansea?
Yeah.
Was that a volley, half volley? What was that?
You just don't know.
Then he put in his skills. No, he does MMA, mixed martial arts.
Yes.
So you could see they marked that ball.
Yeah.
It had some different kind of technique.
Not kawaii. <going.
laughs> That was not a football technique. That was karate.
Ah, sasa then.
That's it from the Three Quarters Podcast crew. We've brought you, of course, Kenya Cup rugby. We've talked about international rugby. We've talked about the Premier League game that's going to be shaping up on Saturday. We're going to be at the Kenya Harlequins or KRFU watching the Harlequins versus Homeboys game.
Oh, yeah. At 4 p.m.
At 4 p.m.
On Saturday.
Make sure you're there because it's going to be live. It's going to be off the hook.
Thank you very much, Joro. It's been a good one.
Till next week, keep it live, keep it locked, keep it ready, keep it three quarters.
Cheers, guys.